Jim and Ashley, in this momentous occasion, Woodland Oaks Project.
Ready?
Bam.
There we go.
There we go. This is the start of $1 million of dirt removal.
Well, we have these already staked,
okay.
And we kind of laid it out. We're going to overcut.
This little affair is only costing us $450, so not setting us back too much.
Beautiful.
Okay, this is April 19th. Hopefully we've all paid our taxes by now.
Ribbon cutting, take one.
There it goes. These are the foam foundations.
Give you a little scale. I'm 6'2".
Saturday, May 3rd, and we're out at the job site pouring concrete today on 1308 and 1312. Sides of the foundations this week, and just to give you a little scale on 1308,
probably about 9-10 feet tall.
It's Thursday, May 29th. Yesterday, and they're going to start dirt work today. This is June 4th, and we are watching the bulldozer take out that hill. massive dirt work going on here. We're about to have our next investor visit. They're coming in tomorrow. I think they're gonna like it. This is June 7th, and this is our third investor meeting, and we are watching the bulldozer move that huge mountain right there to that pile of dirt right there.
Hey, Jim.
First, and the framers are putting on the siding and the roof. This is July 6th. And the houses have been painted, the concrete floors have been stained, and the foundations on 1300 are being formed. For a paint job on 1312. Saturday, July 12th, and we're looking at the retaining walls, and they're continuing to work on the masonry on the outside of the houses.
That's the rough plumbing on 1300. Just past inspection.
All that dirt right there just came out of that hill right there. That's where the 1304 foundation is going.
Hopefully this will give you a little scale of the 1308 house here, how tall it is. The masonry on 1308.
Spanish going on here. Putting in the HVAC systems in 1312 and 1308 here. It's 1312. This is Sunday, August 3rd, and they just finished the retaining wall on 1300, and they're doing the forms for the foundation on the cottage of 1308.
This is the beginning of the frame for the 1308. Cottage foundation. This is the backside of that huge retaining wall I took a picture of at the beginning. Shot of some of the insulation. 1308B garage.
This is Saturday, August 16th, and we're having investor visit number 4. We'll be right back.
is a great shot of woodland from the house just to the northwest of us. Get a look at the retaining walls there.
Maybe 2 months away from this guy.
Hooray!
And we've got a ghost apparently. This is Saturday, August 23rd, and they finished the metal roofs and the retaining wall right over here on 1300 Cottage and drywall.
It's like we've got some plumbing sticking way up out of that retaining wall. You can see that they put the rebar in on top of the 1304 Cottage. Drywall on the downstairs main house, 1308.
This is Saturday, September 20th, and they've taken the boards down on 1304 foundation, and they're about to finish pouring 1300B foundation right here.
Shy of the garage doors there. And the 1300B foundation. The rough plumbing in there. There's Ashley the photographer. And Trina made it out here for a visit with us. Looks like they're beginning to line up the sites for this retaining wall here. We are standing on the 1304 Cottage foundation looking down at the holes that they're drilling for the piers that the porch is going to sit on top of. The 1300B Cottage foundation retaining wall all in one. Thing looks like a fortress.
Vanity bath. Some plumbing fixtures.
The footings for the wood walkway going to our unit, 1308B. And a little pop-out roof there on over our door. Another look at those porch footings.
This is Friday, October 10th, and they're pouring the 1304 foundation. Saturday, October 18th, and I'm standing in the 1300 Cottage. We're looking at the 1300 house framing just to the right of me.
Shot of the backsplash. Light fixtures out above the garage on 1312. Wood floors. Ashley's out of control blender light.
This is Saturday, October 25th, and we are on our fifth investor meeting.
This is the backside of the retaining wall in between the 1304 Cottage and 1308 house. Here's the other side of that retaining wall. Where the stairs are going to be in between the two retaining walls between 1300 and 1304, and those are going to be parking spaces right there, and they're just putting stone over that foundation there, 1304. Also, they
cut the driveway in. So there's gonna be a retaining wall right there. You can see where they're putting the rocks in right now. Here's what the back side of those retaining walls look like. It's all the rock fill in behind there. This is from the porch of the 1300 cottage, looking out on what will eventually be their little courtyard in between 1304 and them. And it has some nice windows in there, just like 1300 main house.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That would be good. This is Saturday, November 15th, and they've finished framing out 1304 main house, garage apartment, and cottage.
This angle is looking out the front door of the 1304 cottage, across their porch, to the walkway over into 1308B. Standing down here away on our property line in the bamboo. Okay, now we're switching over to the funky 1304 garage apartment. Detached. This is the area we've opened up for their extra storage. Here's a shot of the vaulted ceilings in their room with that funky roof angle. Here's what we're affectionately calling the granddaddy. 1304 main house. This is the view looking through the French doors all the way through. There's a back door out of the living room right next to the plethora of windows. Looking out over the main granddaddy tree, oak, the driveway, the cottage, and 1308. The red front door on 1312. And also they've stained the wood there. Looks pretty nice.
This is Saturday, January 31st. It's been a while since our last update, but a lot's happened since then. We've done the final punch out on 1312 and 1308. We have the stakes for the driveway, and they've started putting up some of the forms.
The hand railing in between 1300 and 1304. Stain has been put onto the porch there in 1300B Cottage. There's Ashley on her new iPhone.
This is Tuesday, March 10th, and we are pouring the driveway. This is Sunday, April 19th, and the driveway is completed. We've started on the landscaping, which is going to be finished in a few weeks. We have all of our certificates of occupancy. The gas lines have been hooked up. The yellow front doors have been painted. And Ashley and I have moved into 1308A, and we're performing our on-site property management.
And there's the driveway completed. There's a view of the holes that the city arborist made us drill into our driveway, such that this is yellow front door number one on 1300B. This is looking at the 1304B porch, the lattice work that we installed. 1304B cottage, finished product on the inside. These are the metal grates installed on the driveway coming down from 1304. This is the alternate angle looking at that landscaping installed in front of 1308. Ashley's pet rock right there. Now I am inside the 1304 main house, and I'm giving a pan of the final finish out of what this looks like on the inside.
Update. There's the sign I put up.
Standing in the visitor spots here and just showing off the cool little rock trail that Bill put in. These are our mailbox installation. Front. Back to that vegetation there. This is the island in the middle of the driveway. Look how that turned out. Those guys right there grow up to be about 12 feet tall, Bill was told us. This is a closer up look of the little pop-outs that we installed for the 1304B angled parking spot. The tire stops in there.
It's a Mexican lime tree. Should give us some pretty good limes for our Dos Equis.
The patio here we installed. The grill and torches. Square foot gardens we installed, and you can see the 1308A tenant has already made use of hers. And then this is a good look at our cactus garden that we installed up there on the hill towards the cliff dwelling.